这一群年轻人口中不断喊着正义，但他们并不是因为政治因素而集会，而是为了气候变化的问题。去年八月开始，瑞典籍16岁女孩格丽塔·图恩伯格发起每周五气候集会活动，只希望大人能够应对气候变化。而这个气候变化的集会也影响了大马的年轻人。
We are striking every Friday to remind the politics and the government to look at the climate change.
We talk about how we love our children, but we're not realizing how we are forsaking their future.
I would like to see a future where everyone comes together to actually care about the environment. I think it's really sad how many people are unaware and uneducated about this. But I also feel like the government should actually implement not only laws, but education.
事实上，在3月15号这一天，全球各地都在进行周五气候变化抗议活动。
Our Earth is dying. With every day that passes, we shall know that.
而在马来西亚，有一群不相识但却志同道合的青少年，在打卖轻快铁砖，聚集在一块儿响应这个抗议活动。
I actually know about this event from Ideal Twitter. As much as most of us who come here, it's about Greta Thunberg having to create a change, right?So she fights for the Fridays for Future.
What really inspires me to start this event is because in Malaysia, no one is doing anything about climate change. And so I'm inspired by Greta Thunberg. And I knew her from social media, and she's pretty viral on social media, and her movement is big now. And I'm inspired to do it myself in Malaysia because no one has started it.
I showed up because I think that it's my responsibility as a youth to actually encourage other youth to join in any kind of environmental efforts and actually promote a sustainable way of living.
这群年轻人都是抱着一股热血开始举办集会，没想到却面对许多的阻挠。但是最后看到现场的出席者，让他们感到欣慰，觉得大马还是有人关注气候变化的课题。
Today is actually the first one where I face the problem with the police about permission. My university is not being very helpful. They advised me to walk outside because they don't want.
Like if you walk into a palm oil plantation, I don't know if you've done that before. You don't hear animals.It's like completely quiet. No birds, no insects. It just doesn't feel right. You know that you're in a jungle, but something is missing.
The earth is in trouble. All right, and we're dying as fast as we can.
If you want to make a change, you have to start from yourself. Like for me, I've reduced my waste a lot. I've stopped using single-use plastic as much as I can. I've gone vegetarian. I have actually started separating all of my recyclables and my non-recyclables.
I personally choose not to drive here in KL. I don't own a car here. I use public transport all the time. The clothes that you see me wearing right now, these are from bundle stores. The shoes that I'm wearing, that were actually used to belong to my brothers. So I rarely buy new things unless I really need it.
I'm really happy that we have a really amazing minister on board.Right, and she's very proactive, she's very diligent, she's determined in addressing climate change action. I think on part of Malaysia, because we do address policies, right? We do address laws are very strict in a sense. But however, behind those closed doors, you know, what's the decision that's been made always has been politicized. It's always a different agenda, right? So what I call out is to adults or anybody who wants to be a part of the change, is that they need to understand their personal perspective.On the ecosystem. They need to understand as an individual and how they can create a collective movement like what we're doing right now, the youth movement, into addressing climate change action.
我们只有一个地球，气候变迁已经在发生，而你做出行动了吧。
It's for everyone, you know. You can't just think of yourself, you have to think about everyone. Every little thing that you do counts and it has a huge impact on everyone and everything in this world.